She slept with two of my ex-boyfriends, including the guy I lost my virginity to. Kids born to teen moms, how different is your life compared to other kids? I was born in 1964, when my mother was 16. Grandparents adopted me, so I'd have a name. Father's family paid for the hospital bills and that was it, because they didn't want to ruin his chances to go to VMI. Mother had three other kids from at least two other men, and tried to treat me like a little sister, although a girl in third grade decided it was her duty to tell me I didn't really have a daddy. Three-bedroom country farm with four kids, grandparents, and mother with her pedo husband, was a constant fight complete with fists, and screaming almost daily. At least we could go outside. Lost a brother to a gunshot, when stepfather cheated on mother, and left gun down, while he was leaving, other brother accidentally shot him. Mother continued to treat me like a sister, until she decided she wanted to be a mother. My grandmother was the one who raised me, and the one I consider my true mother. When she died, she left me the land with her house on it, and my mother tricked me into signing it over to her. I was very naive. She accused my straight-edge gothy kids, in their 30s now, of being on drugs, because they wore black, and has held a remark one made about moving away, when I was 16 against me to this day. My father sent me $50 when I graduated, and $100 when I got married the first time. And I had no idea he was even my father, until I was 23. I would have liked to have had a different childhood. My mom and I are really close. She had me at 14. Growing up, I noticed a lot of my friends didn't get along with their moms. I always thought she was really relatable. We go eat, go shopping, get coffee, gossip, just hang out. She worked a lot, sometimes multiple jobs at once, so I felt like I did less extracurricular than my friends. But I was pretty happy growing up. She is always concerned with money. I'm starting to notice that she's not very good at saving money, or planning retirement and whatnot. I once asked a family friend, now that us kids are grown, how are my parents still living paycheck to paycheck? She explained that, in her opinion, my mom basically skipped learning how to take care of herself as an adult. Instead of learning how to effectively adult, she focused on taking care of her kids. I will forever be grateful for my mom and the hard work and sacrifices she endured to raise me and my siblings. My BO parents were 14 and 15 when I was born. They opted for a closed adoption, but my BO mom did leave a thoughtful gift for me. My mom told me that my BO mom was very kind, and through the pregnancy, was always really worried about me. She made a lot of watercolor paintings with poems for me when she was pregnant, and gave them to my mom. My mom had them bound in a book for me, and would read them to me when I was little. Some of them talk about how she can feel me moving around, and what my heartbeat sounded like. It's odd because they really look like a child did them, and I can't believe how much she went through at a young age. I think this made me more compassionate towards girls than other boys were in middle school and high school. Mom was 15 when she had me. Honestly, my life sucked. She used to say that she could have given me up for adoption, and then decided not to because she realized that I would love her unconditionally no matter what. Our relationship progressed pretty negatively because of that mindset of hers. Every negative thing I did was against what she thought motherhood would be like. I was something she could pick up and put down and leave behind at her leisure. There were a number of times she'd drop me off at a family member's house and disappear. Once, I came home from kindergarten and no one was there. Dad was in prison. The next morning, my uncle showed up. He had heard my mom left, and had a gut feeling he needed to go to my house. There was no food and the heat had been turned off by the utility company. I don't remember much about that time other than the peanut butter and jelly sandwiches and the Demolition Man movie. She had pretty bad trauma, and never processed it properly, so when she got angry due to a trauma reminder, she got angry. When she was good, boy, she was golden. She could be the most fun of a person you could ask for, but she wasn't a mother. She never held and comforted, she expected hugs and comfort. She was a kid, and thought with a kid brain. When we had some spare change, she'd walk me to the ice cream place and she'd buy herself an ice cream and we'd go back home. As I got older, our already weird relationship became weirder. She told me she didn't want people to know she was my mom and I could introduce her as my sister. She would tell people that she had 3 children, my siblings, and not claim me because people would do the math. She wanted to be friends with my friends. She wanted to hang around when they were there. What I know about having a teenage mom is this: I loved her with the kind of fanatical worship that messed me up for a long time. She could be funny and cruel at the same time. When she gave you attention, your world would be brighter, but when she was mad at you, the world would be dark. She never grew out of her teenage mindset, and I had to come to grips with that. I can't say that every teenage mom is like mine, but mine was rough. I was primarily raised by my grandparents after age 5, because my mom couldn't handle the responsibility, and my dad wanted nothing to do with us. She neglected me, literally played World of Warcraft, and slept all hours of the day. There were times when I'd miss school because she wouldn't get up, or I would have to eat uncooked frozen waffles because I was so hungry. I had to grow up really quickly because of that. When my grandparents moved us in, it was better, but she always acted more like a sibling. When she lived with us, she would argue with me and steal my things and go on and on about how everyone thinks she's my sister and not my mom. She tried to squeeze some more youth into her life when I was young, always partying and drinking and coming home ducked up. She constantly brought me around her trash boyfriends, including a stalker, a man who is now white supremacist, and a man who got convicted of S**XULLY assaulting his ex-stepdaughter who was the same age as me during their relationship. By the time I was 10, I was already significantly more mature than her. She resents me for that, as well as my intelligence and academic success and the fact that I'm happy when she never got to be, despite her best efforts to duck me up psychologically. I get to live my life and she never did. She started doing drugs at some point in there, not sure when, but she stopped and got her life together when she got pregnant with my little brother. Didn't last long. She's in rehab now, and my little brother is a victim to the same circumstances that I was. She hasn't grown at all. Having me at a young age must have stunted her growth or something, because she's the most immature person I know. She tried to make it all up to me when I was 18 by taking me on a trip to Europe, but she ended up losing my passport and then left without me while I had to figure out how to return to the US all by myself. Goes to show how little changed. My whole childhood I felt like an outsider because of her. I'm from a middle class suburb with more nuclear families than not, so everyone treated me like some alien. That, or they'd look at me like I was a heartless B**TCH if I said I don't celebrate Mother's Day, or if I couldn't remember her birthday. I could sense the caution people used around me, like I was covered in cracks and would shatter instantly if someone even looked at me funny. That definitely affected the way I treated myself for a while. In actuality though, I was mostly fine. I was insecure and struggled with some abandonment sensitivity, but aside from that, I was pretty happy. My grandparents are amazing people, and they always did the best they could to encourage and support me when I was young. I never felt unloved or unwanted, just frustrated I had no chance at a normal life. I never realized how little those things matter once you get past high school though, how unimportant normally is. I realize now I'm better off having gone through all that at a young age. I have a good head on my shoulders because, starting from a young age, I had to be mature enough for both my mom and myself. I struggle with anxiety, but it's mostly internal. Nothing outside of that ever really phases me. As soon as I got to college, I rejected my past and became extremely independent, and I've come to realize that doing things on my own is where I thrive. I know I will never be like her, and I know my success will only spite her more, and that serves to motivate me. I love who I'm now, and I know I wouldn't be this way if she hadn't fumbled so hard. Sorry, this turned into more of a rant than an answer. With my mom and rehab right now leaving my little brother to fend for himself, like she did to me, I guess I was waiting for an opportunity like this to talk some SH asterisk T. My mom is 15 years older than me, and has banged 7 of my friends throughout my life. For when I was still in high school. Other than that, I think I was became mature than her when I was 12. I took care of my 3 siblings, did the cooking, cleaning, got them to school. Hell, I started working 40 hours/week at 14, so my siblings could have some sort of a normal childhood, get clothes, school supplies. I even took them go-karting on each of their birthdays. Those are some of my favorite memories. Overall, I think that my childhood sucked. I never got to be a kid. I don't think anyone should have kids before they are mature enough to handle one, and teen moms should have a lot, if oversight by CPS. My mother resented me. Still does actually, but it's lessened over the years. It was apparently my fault she missed her teen years, so she dropped me off at a relative's in another state when I was a toddler, and hitchhiked around the country for a year. As I grew up, I was screamed at and beaten for looking like my biological father. She didn't trust me a bit because of it. I had to get permission to step outside to get the mail, couldn't bathe myself until I was a teenager, couldn't do homework with others. I don't think it has ever occurred to her I'm not guilty of anything. But in her eyes, being my father's daughter is enough. It was bad. They were horrible trash humans that messed me up pretty bad. I was shuffled from house to house to house and didn't find a stable home until I was a teenager, and that was with grandparents. I have trust issues, abandonment issues, but in other areas of my life I'm successful. I did amazing in school because it was my safe place. I became a teacher. I'm married and have 2 kids, both of whom I was married while having and out of college. My mom was 16 when she had me. Dad was out of the picture shortly after. Grew up poor, moved around probably 20 times between different apartments. She partied a lot while I was growing up and was never a good example. I dropped out of high school because I never had anyone motivating me to do well, and I resent her for that. I never went to prom or had any of the typical high school experiences. When I was a teenager, she got really competitive with me, always trying to prove she was young and cool. She slept with 2 of my ex-boyfriends, including the guy I lost my virginity to. She became friends with a group of teenagers, like 14 to 18 year olds, which was super weird. Eventually, she got into hard drugs, and still is to this day. Thankfully, I got away from her, and I haven't seen her in 7 years. I'm 27 now, college educated, have a good career, don't drink or smoke, don't have any kids, been through a lot of therapy. I learned what not to do from her, I guess. Thank you for watching. Hit like and subscribe for more videos.